splatter, the most spectacular techniques in trials, when it's done properly. Truth to be told, I've been working on splatters for some times, and I never had it right till I met Ryan Young, Jordi Pasquet, and Tino Martinez. Those three guys, they helped me a lot with splatters, but I also had the chance to refresh and review those splatters with Rafał Luberda and Tom Hajduk from Poland. And those guys, they are professional riders, and they helped me a lot to understand why and how, which elements are actually crucial. So I tremendously am very grateful for those guys to help me. So as you can see on the slow motion, I did a little bit like a small pre-jump, which helped me to push the bike down on a kicker. Kicker, it's very important. The position of the kicker, it's almost the same height as the distance from the wall. If this is a 5 feet wall, the kicker is 5 feet apart from it. The second important part with the splatter is to have the throttle open. A lot of people keep the finger on the front lever, and it's no way that they can have a full power open if they keep the front brake finger on the front brake lever. The second thing, which is very important, Oliver is not doing this, it's to push the suspension down, which helps to preload the suspension. Now, the timing of this is very important. If I if I push the suspension before the kicker, or if I delay this the preloading after the kicker, I just basically lose everything. So the timing is very important of pushing the suspension down. Oliver, what he's doing here, he's in a sitting position. This time he pushed bike a little bit down, but it wasn't enough. And also his problem was that he didn't have enough of throttle open. So you need to push your bike down. The way how I'm doing it, I just raise a little bit on my toes. Let's go imagine that you are in a gym, and then you have to go from the floor, jump from the floor to a high gym crate. So basically what you do before you jump on this crate, you raise on your toes a little bit, you go down with your bum, and then about three quarters down, you don't go all the way down so your bum is actually touching your heels, but you go as low as you can, almost like a immediate stop deceleration. All of a sudden, when you decelerate, when you are in the position of returning, you jump really high, and then it gives you this kind of the explosive power, which is very important. The same is here in trials. The key element with majority of the techniques, it's a timing. So if I approach the kicker very fast, I don't have a time to push the suspension down, because the bike runs very fast, the obstacle just goes very fast towards me, and the timing is crucial, yeah? So I look at the obstacle constantly. You need to have the visual contact with the obstacle, with the wall you're riding on. A lot of people keeps the head down. So there are a few elements, head down, keeping finger on their front brake, not opening enough of throttle, don't push the suspension down, they don't jump off the pegs, they don't move the shoulder backwards, so the bike just goes flat and hit with the skid plate. So as you can see on the slow motion here, I push the suspension on the kicker, and when I'm down in suspension, my throttle was wide open, and then I jump off the pegs, release the clutch very fast, or some people say dump at the clutch, and then the bike just basically go up and had the time to rotate. So the front wheel goes up over vertical. This in this situation didn't go over vertical, but people like Tony Bu and pro riders, they will do over vertical. So the rear tire slams towards the wall, climbs the wall, and have a time to drop on the other side of the wall. Even with this technique, roll up, I will go down my knees. When I go down, I have my throttle open, and then dump the clutch, and it just helps me to go up the wall. the gears you're going to use, it's usually second or third gear. And then depends if at the beginning of the movie we've been practicing the small splatters, small jumps on a wet surface. I think it was better to do it on the third gear. And the reason was that it was just basically too slippery on the second gear. It was, the second gear was creating a lot of slipping. So the third gear gave me a lot of advantage. Okay. I hope that this will help you with your splatters. Good luck.